Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. So in the last lesson, we created our store, which will store the news data. Then we implemented some methods to perform different operations on our table in the database. Now one thing I left off in the last lesson was handling these errors appropriately. So in this lesson, we are going to create custom errors, mark the errors with appropriate status code so that the caller can respond to the client appropriately with the HTTP status code. So here, I'm just going to create a new file called error.go. Again, packages news. Now, I will create a custom error type. Custom error, which is a struct. First thing is the error or the error that custom error is wrapping. Then we will also have a HTTP status field, which will be of type int. Now, let's create a constructor function for it. We say new custom error, accept the error and HTTP status, returning a pointer to custom error. Now we will just do return custom error, error, provided error, then HTTP status that we get. Now I'm going to implement the error and unwrap methods on it. Let's create them function custom error and then error. This method is to satisfy the error interface. Here we just return the underlying error message. So we will do c.error. That's it. Now the next method is unwrap, so that the error we are wrapping can be unwrapped. Return the error, return the underlying error, which is c.error. And the last method that I'm going to have here is called HTTP status code. So I can say t custom error HTTP status code, return the int. Here we just say c.http status. Now, you may not understand it now why we are returning a HTTP status, but when we start using the store in the handlers, you will know how we are going to use the HTTP status code. Let's update our store to return appropriate errors with the HTTP status code set. For when there is an error with great news, we want to return new custom error with the underlying error and the HTTP status code of internal server error. Because if we fail to create a record in our DB, this means there was some issue with the DB operation itself. In that case, we want to send internal server error. Now, for find by ID, if we can't find the record, then we should be sending status not found. So let's do that. So I will say if error is error SQL error no rows, that is no rows were found with that ID, can just do return news and then new custom error, pass the error and then status not found. Otherwise, if there's any other error, that means there were some problems connecting to the DB. So in that case, we will just say error HTTP dot status internal server error. For find all, we don't need to do anything. So we can just say news and error as a return value. In case of delete by ID, if error is actually record not found, that is errors is error SQL dot no rows, that means that the record doesn't exist. So in that case, we will just say return, because from the application perspective, it is already deleted or not there in the database. In any other case, we want to return HTTP dot internal server error. Now we were ignoring the result first, but we are going to use it to return an appropriate error. For this case, if there's any error, we will just do error HTTP dot status internal server error. Otherwise, we check the rows affected error r dot rows affected. Here I just need to add a colon. So r dot rows affected, which is a method on the return results. If error not is equal to nil, that is we weren't able to get the number of rows affected, we just do return new custom error, error HTTP dot status internal server error. In other case, when rows affected is equal to zero, we just do return new custom error, error HTTP dot status not found. That is no rows were affected, which means our where clause couldn't find anything in the database. So with this, we have our store set up. To revise, we created a custom error struct that is a wrapper around error and HTTP status. We also implemented the methods error to satisfy the error interface, unwrap to actually unwrap the original error, and then HTTP status code. Inside store, depending on the error we were getting, we return appropriate HTTP status like status not found when there are no rows in find by ID. Now we have implemented the store, but how do we test it to see if what we have written here or our coding logic is working as expected? For that, in the next lesson, we will use test containers to test these DB operations. That's it for this lesson. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!